Posted the entire video on BillO'Reilly.com. With us now here in New York City, Joe Concha, columnist for Mediaite. And joining us on the phone from Florida, Don Browne, former NBC News Bureau Chief in Miami, was in charge of news coverage in Central and South America, including the coverage of the Falklands War and the Salvadoran War. Mr. Browne, begin with you. You've read the Mother Jones article on me. What's your assessment of the situation?
Well, there are two things. Number one, I was surprised at the article because, interesting enough, you came on my radar. I was overseeing the coverage in El Salvador, which was a brutal war. You were there to cover the war because it was an opportunity for young journalists to get their ticket punched. And that was a time when satellites were had just come online, and that was a war that was the number one news story at the time. So you came down to get your ticket punched, and you did.
And we went up to Morazan, which was the most dangerous province. We did a story up there, as you know. And then we segued down to the Falklands War. Now, you were overseeing the coverage there in the Falklands. You know what happened that night when Galtieri's government surrendered to the British. In my reporting, I told it exactly the way it was. Or did I make any mistakes, Mr. Browne?
No, let me give you the progression of the war. At first, it was a joke. Nobody took it seriously. We had the only reporter that actually got on the Falkland Islands. Robin Lloyd actually got there through the Argentine Navy. As the war went badly, there were demonstrations every day. There were tanks in the street. It was a country at war. At first, it was casual, and it became more and more serious. And as the military were losing badly, the populace began to turn on the military leadership.
Now, you say there were tanks in the streets. You mean the streets of Buenos Aires, where we all were?
There were tanks in the streets. Yes, it was a real country at war. It wasn't a joke. It was a real war, and they were taking it very seriously. And at first, Buenos Aires was a pretty nice place to be if you were covering the war. But as it turned out, it got progressively more intense.
I got there only 3 days before that giant riot, so I didn't participate in all the fun that you guys might have had. But your correspondents were with me in the Plaza de Mayo when the riot broke out. What did your correspondents tell you about the danger that they witnessed and indeed experienced?
Well, these were veteran correspondents. We saw the situation escalating. They weren't surprised. But they were surprised at the overreaction, but to them it was business as usual. That's what they were down there to do. It didn't happen one day. It was the progression that led up to you call it a riot. It was a very intense situation where people got hurt, and there was a very serious confrontation. And it was a defining moment when the populace really turned on the military.
It was extremely violent from the street where I was, and we couldn't get casualty numbers because, as you know, it was a military dictatorship, and they don't give that to you. But I saw people hit the ground hard. I saw them hauled off, put into ambulances and police vehicles, and the local reportage was that there were fatalities. We have not been able to say how many. All right, but I believe there were. And in the New York Times article, there's Mizell did a pretty good job. You know, everybody was trying to get the numbers, but the numbers were impossible to get. But there is no doubt that this was an extremely violent and volatile situation where reporters were in danger. Or am I wrong?
No, it was. And any situation like that, when you bring that kind of intensity together in a protest where the police and, in this case, the military are reacting aggressively, it's a dangerous cocktail.
But nobody said it was a walk in the park, did they, Mr.
Browne? Not at all. This is a very serious situation where a lot of people died.
On both sides,
the British and the Argentine.
900 deaths on the island, and we don't know how many deaths in Buenos Aires. But I really appreciate you standing up because, you know, there's a lot of pressure to make this a political issue. But you have a sterling reputation, Mr. Browne. You've been there.